Guys, what's good? Welcome back to the channel. So glad to have you. I wanted to get this review up and uploaded before we headed to Nebraska so you guys would understand kind of the gear we're using out there. But our good buddies, Jacob at Outdoor Vision Gear, hooked us up with the all-new Turkey Pro 1. You guys have seen on social media, been released in the last couple weeks. A lot of guys are going vestless. It's kind of intimidating for me. I like taking a lot of crap with me in the turkey woods. Always have since I was about 10. Always had a turkey vest. So this is all new territory for me. We're gonna have to really slim down the system, take the essentials, but I think this thing's gonna have just enough room for really everything you're gonna need chasing that long beard, whether you're here in Georgia, out west, Nebraska. Shout out to Preston, Nebraska Spur Chasers, buddy. We are 4 days away from getting the rental and packing it out and heading your way. So buddy, hang tight, we're coming. But guys, stay tuned. This review is gonna be awesome. Real short, I know you guys are on your lunch break, maybe in between hunts checking this out, so I appreciate you. Make sure you check us out on Instagram, MojoBuck80. Like I said, we're headed west in like 4 days, so a lot of content coming. And, you know, the good Lord willing, maybe we can get hands on a Merriam out there. But guys, stay tuned. Thanks again for watching.
With my bare two hands, end up in jail eating microwave hell, but I'm a little smarter than that.
Guys, like I said, thanks for tuning in to this video. I wanted to give you just a quick overview of this new Turkey Pro 1 system by our guys at Outdoor Vision. Talked with Jacob. Really, that was the brains behind this thing. He really did a lot of research, and obviously he's a turkey hunter himself. So going from a vest to something like this that is just so streamlined and tight to the body is a vast difference, you know, in kind of what you're running. So the whole idea behind this system is to keep everything in front of you, know exactly where everything is, so even in the dark, I can feel around and find these magnetic striker holders. I can find these pot call holders. I can reach in, you know, these really high quality zipper pulls. That would remind you of my turkey vest. Reach in, grab my light, grab a snack, my phone. It's all been well thought out. It's not like a guy that just builds binocular harnesses or their other products, you know, said, hey, we need to get in the turkey game. Let's go ahead and build something that's, you know, we can market and get out there really quickly. It's not the case with this. This is, like I said, a really highly thought out piece of gear that I think a lot of you guys benefit from. So me personally, like I said earlier, I've been running a turkey vest for forever. I mean, I was like 13 years old, bought my first Primos turkey vest, seat built in, specialized pockets, that whole, you know, nine yards. Well, I still like a turkey vest. I think it should be a part of your arsenal, but I think this is a great piece of gear to enhance what you already have in your turkey system, to make yourself that much more adaptable, have that many more tools in your tool belt to chase that tom turkey if he's not gonna just do it, you know, read the script like they normally don't. Guys, so again, the design of this thing was super well thought out. I really like how they incorporated some of their binocular harness or you know, the harness for optics out west into this product as well. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and show you how easy this thing is to take off. And I've only had this thing for probably just a couple days now. I got it in the mail. But you've got a really nice harness back here. I like how it's not just straps. See if I can focus on this. I like how it's not just strapped X back here. So if they can get really twisted up when you're in a rush, throwing this in and out of the truck, getting out, chasing that bird through the woods. I like how this is just one solid piece. I really like this olive green color. As you can see here in Georgia, everything's kind of bloomed out now, so everything's really green. They do make this in a coyote tan as well, but they've got their logo on the back. You've got really nice structured buckles on the front with keepers for your, I've got this thing, I like it kind of high up on my chest where I can get to it. I got this thing cinched down pretty good. The side entry and exits, you only got to have one undone. go ahead and don this thing real quick. And you can see I've got my new Sitka hoodie on right here, the Core Lightweight hoodie. This thing utilizes a built-in face mask and a hood, and literally the straps don't hinder any of that. So you can see I've still got access to the hood here. I've got access to everything up front. It's real slimline. It reminds you of like a chest carrier or a plate carrier for a, you know, like you see the guys overseas wearing. But I like this design. I like this up front. It reminds you of those old school turkey vests. I think the Tactical Tater from a crazy name, right? From Cabela's. But I just like this system. I'm glad they went with this. I'm glad they didn't have stuff like on your sides here. I did hear that they are going to expand this with a possible seat, you know, somehow make a seat where you can flip up and at least have a seat cushion, because I think that's a big advantage to a vest, right? You don't get your butt wet on the leaves, or you're not in some cactus or desert, whatever your environment is chasing that bird. You can, you know, keep your rump away from the elements. But I think that stuff's coming, so bear with them. Also, let's see here. You've got ventilated mesh on the inside. Let's see if this will focus on that. You got ventilated mesh here on the inside of this thing, so it'll keep you off next to skin or next to clothes right here. It's not going to really sweat you out that bad. You can breathe a little bit. But overall, I like how this thing sits on the chest. I like how it's mobile. I like how I can cinch it down to where if I'm running and gunning, it's really not going to move. But overall, guys, I think you killed this product. All right, guys, so as I mentioned earlier, we're going to compare this to my current system, which is the Alps Impact Vest, the one without the internal seat frame, because that thing weighs a ton. But anyway, the thing I have in this vest, yeah, I like where all the placements are, but really I have everything I need in here plus the kitchen sink. I mean, I have fly-down wings, you know, thermosel, turkey totes, knives, box calls, two pots, stuff to condition the pots. I've got two pairs of gloves, two masks. I've got all this crap, right, is what it boils down to. When really, when you're running and gunning after that long beard, all you really need is for me, it's a diaphragm call and a shotgun. So if I'm taking off through the woods, I'm ditching this thing, and most of the time dropping a pin on it because I'm probably going to lose it, and then going after that bird. It happened to me opening day with Candace. We're out there, I'm filming her. Bird ended up moving on us. Watched him, you know, breed a hen for an hour. I had to ditch this vest because I knew I was going to have to go up a ridgeline, you know, go through several blowdowns, creek bottoms, and get up there to him. I didn't want this vest with me. I just feel like it's creeping through the woods. I feel like all this is kind of restrictive. And even if I'm sitting down, set up on a bird, if I got to move really quickly, I'm attached by that seat. And so these straps, like if I'm strapped up here, I've got to unbuckle this. I've got a quick disconnect here with a strap here so I can throw this strap off. It's just a lot going on. With that thing there, the Turkey Pro 1, it's all right here. I can move side to side movement. I can grab my gun. I can grab my camera. I can do whatever I need to do, and I don't have to, you know, unstrap out of that thing. It's already right here. So let's give a little bit deeper dive into this. Let's get a tabletop. Let's kind of compare some specs between my Alps and this Outdoor Vision Gear Turkey Pro 1, kind of see how the calls fit in correlation to how I want this thing laid out for our trip out west next week. So stay with us. All right, guys, we're back with a tabletop overview, kind of give you a rough idea of what I've stripped out of the Alps over there. It's kind of out of frame, this section of the tabletop. But yeah, I do carry the kitchen sink with me. Yeah, I'm probably guilty of that, like most turkey hunters are. I'd rather have it, not need it, than wish I had it, kind of principle there. But kind of stripping all the essentials out, I really thought about if I'm going to chase after a bird, what I might need, or if I'm going to, you know, start out from the truck lightweight, as in this Turkey Pro 1, kind of see what I'm going to roll with. So obviously I've still got room for a thermosel. I've got a sharp knife. You know, luckily if you harvest a bird, you're going to need a knife. I've got my pod call here. I just got this pod call. I think it's freaking sweet. I've got some conditioner, Scotch-Brite for the pod call. So I've got that. I've got some box call chalk, because if you're going to carry a box call, guys, carry some freaking chalk. I mean, come on. I hate seeing the guy run a box call and he's like, oh, I don't have any chalk. Don't be that guy. Buy you some Glad bags, keep that, chop you a dollar store piece of chalk in half and run with it that way. I've got a couple strikers here, so I've got two different options as far as hens for that pod call. I always like having an extra striker. I've got my 20 gauge shells here for old Steve. Things are bad, mamba jamba. I've got my lens pin for the camera like I'm running here. Got a nice bright headlamp with a white and red light combo. Got my Headhunter box call. Shout out Neil Jacobs. I've got my dark water tote, turkey tote that, man, this thing has come in handy this year. Shout out to Landon there. I've got some a three-pack of diaphragms from Foot on the Head. These things are by far my favorite. In a compact case, that's kind of key. Make sure you've got one of those cases. And if you're feeling squirrely, you got your avian steak. I don't know if this will fit. I feel like it will. I've got an idea where I want to put it. But if you are going to start out from the get-go and run a decoy, you got to have steak, right? So the avians that I run are off camera over there, but they've got their own bag, so you don't have to worry about throwing a decoy in here like you would in a turkey vest. Obviously, you just throw it in the sack, throw it over your shoulder like your shotgun, hit the woods, you still got all your stuff here on your chest. So let's get this stowed away, kind of see how the system works, and we'll see it in just 1 second. All right, guys, so switching all this stuff over from the Turkey Pro 1, like I said, from the vest to this system, it's kind of seamless. This stuff fit like a glove. It's got its own specific call pockets, organization pockets, closures, magnetic stuff. It's made for turkey hunting. Like I said, this was made for turkey hunters by turkey hunters. The only issue I had is this new pod call from Foot on the Head. It is a little big for this pouch, so I wasn't able to utilize that for this particular slate call. I think if you had a smaller diameter, it'd be perfect, right? So I was able to not waste these pockets. I still used it for my box call chalk in there. I've got this, I love this net holder right here. Let's get this camera to focus. I love this net enclosure. It's silent. I can reach in, grab my mouth calls, slide them back in there. It didn't make a peep. Also, up top, I've got room for my conditioners for my slate call. So that's all squared away. Magnetic silent closures for your strikers right here. That is freaking killer. It's literally the quietest thing you can do. No zipper, no button on the market. It's going to be as quiet as a magnet. They killed that part. Secondary pocket, you're going to move on into. Looks like we've got two net pockets with zipper closures. That's perfect for maps, licenses, wallets, if your wallet will fit in there. I utilize these back row right here. Get out of the way. These back pockets here literally was made for my turkey tote. I've got my brush for my camera, as you guys saw earlier, and I've got my knife back there for skinning that bird out. Moving on to the back pocket area, I've got my neck gaiter, my gloves, my headlamp. I mean, literally made for it, guys. The back pocket, like on the breakdown earlier, it is like a vented mesh. So if it is next to your body, obviously the way you wear it, it would be. It's not going to sweat you out. It's kind of breathable. This is perfect for a cell phone. Kangaroo pouch for your cell phone. That's going to work out awesome. You've got another net pocket on the side if you wanted to throw your mouth calls or a flashlight or whatever in this side. It's, again, super quiet. And probably the number one thing that design-wise is killer on this thing is this box call holder. This is perfect to slide, you know, majority of your bigger box calls in here. Small boxes would fit good too. It's adjustable on the back side. You've got a bungee system that retains this silent system. There is no way this thing is going to make a noise in here. I mean, it's completely quiet. So when I'm walking through the woods, you're not going to get that typical, you know, clucking action you are from when you're not, you know, when your box call is stowed, typical of your vest design. So right here, I've got a shelf specific. It's perfect for 20 gauge, as you see here. Obviously, 12 gauge will fit as well. And I've adapted the other side to run my avian stake, so I can easily slide it in and out if I'm going to run a decoy. If I'm not running a decoy, I'll just leave this in the truck. So like I said, guys, this system is adaptable to really how you turkey hunt, what you use, the gear you call turkey in with, and I think it's going to be a game changer for a lot of people. All right, so this is the Turkey Pro 1 fully loaded. As you just saw, the breakdown of where everything's, you know, located at in this system. You know, it's really not that bad. You know, the streamlined version of the turkey vest that we just went from, you know, it's still compact. It's still right there on my chest. I can tighten these up a little bit because under load, I think I do want to take this slack up just a hair. But that's the great thing with this buckle system is it's really just adaptable to what you've got on. See, I've got a real thin layer, the Sitka Core hoodie right here. So it's perfect. And another design feature that Jacob mentioned is they made it in solid colors. So you don't feel like you have to match your camo system. It really is adaptable to any kind of turkey hunter out there, whether you run subalpine, mossy oak, real tree, whatever. Pick the green, pick the Kodiak brown, you know, you're going to be fine. But yeah, under load, guys, this thing's great. I mean, I really like how streamlined it is. I like how tight it is. I've got access to my shells, my stakes, you know, friction calls, mask, gloves, headlamp. You know, heck, I could even strap my thermocell on. Guys, thanks again for tuning into the video. I love bringing you guys gear reviews, especially during the season, so maybe you can adapt some situations that you've been through already and really see the reason why you'd want to pick up your own turkey system from Outdoor Vision Gear. But guys, I'm going to have a link in the description below. Check it out. Pick up your own Turkey Pro 1 system. Fit it to your stuff. Arrange it how you want. Be more agile, adaptive in the woods. Put the miles on. You're not going to have a vest to restrict you. Like I said, it's not a vest replacement totally. It's just something to have in your bag of tricks to have when you got a running gun. Man, this is perfect. It's so compact, keeping the truck. It's going to save you a lot of time. Guys, thanks again for watching. Stay tuned next week. Like I said, we leave to Nebraska Sunday. It's going to be awesome. I can't wait to get out there and really put this thing to test. Guys, have a great week. We'll see you on the next one.
You're crying from those eyes, screaming, never looks too long.